Yes.
So that's a good question. So the question is how do you know that most of the companies are going to do this? Well, we talked to Daly's, Gate, a bunch of them throughout the state of Florida, and they all said yes, absolutely. And I think the reason is it makes financial sense for them because they make a lot of money when people come into their store and buy things. I'm one of them. I mean, I buy so much stuff when I go into the gas station. I know probably half the Wawa employees. I know a lot of the Buc-ee's, because we come here and we buy things. And so I think that that's what they're going to do. It's also a very competitive market. I mean, you know, if a Buc-ee's is lowering the price and someone across the street is not, well, guess what? He's got almost 100 gas pumps out there. People are going to come here to be able to save because, you know, you fill up a tank, if you're saving 25 cents a gallon, you know, that's a pretty good savings. So I'm confident that people understand it's a good idea and that the consumer will see some relief. Now, one of the things that is just something that may happen is, you know, we're at 334 a gallon now, but it could increase from here given what's going on in the overall economy. And so by the time we do this, I mean, I'm hoping it goes down anyways, but I think most people are looking at this saying that these prices are probably going to be high for a while. So whatever that price is, then that's where you'll take the gas tax relief out of whatever the price is at the time that this goes into effect. Well, you know, that's what you guys have opportunities to vote every 2 or 4 years. Yes, sir.
Gas taxes by $1 billion, and we have a dire need, especially right here in Daytona Beach, right here in the LPGA area, for more roads.
We will fully fund the work program, 100%. And in fact, we probably may even end up having more going in the work program. I mean, we have the resources to be able to meet needs and to be able to do. I would say the one thing that is just an issue, because you're seeing it throughout the economy, the inflation hurts us too in the state level, because this stuff becomes more expensive. It's harder to get contractors that can do it, because they're stretched thin in terms of what they're doing. But in terms of having the resources, we have the resources. And so we'll make sure, you know, I said we're going to do the budget probably the first or second week of December, whenever, right before it's due. And you will see a fully funded work program, and we'll make sure we do that. That will include, well, we'll fully fund. I mean, Kevin can talk about, you know, we didn't miss a beat last year. And in fact, we probably were able to accelerate things. So we're going to continue to do that. It's very, very important. And if you look, we had great announcements about what we were doing in the Tampa Bay area with some huge projects. And we're going to see those all over the state. So we continue with that. We're doing infrastructure, not just roads, including roads, also the water resources, all that. That's what happens when you have, I mean, we probably have never had such strong reserves in the history of the state. So we have the ability to provide relief for people, and I don't think we're going to miss a beat. So it'll be in January, and so we'll be able to meet in January, and we've got a busy agenda, but this will be important. This will be something that I think a lot of Floridians are going to want to see, and I think it'll make a big difference for an awful lot of people. You know, I thought about, we've probably got, how many of you are visiting from out of state back there in the crowd? We got Pennsylvania. Where else do we have? Everyone else local? Georgia, Michigan. We've got a lot of other folks. You know, it is interesting how, because we have so many people coming here, that that a lot of these taxes, sales taxes, hotel, I mean, we really do get a lot of people out of state that contribute. That's one of the reasons we have the lowest per capita tax burden. And the what's that? Oh, they are? Okay. Well, yes. You know, the Canadians, it was interesting. Throughout this whole time, the Canadians, that we have snowbirds who were here in the last winter, and Yeah, they were not being treated very well in Canada. They weren't even eligible for vaccine. And so, you know, we said if you have property here and you're a part-time resident, you know, we would treat you accordingly. They were very appreciative of that. But I'm glad that that's the case. And hopefully, in Florida, our tourism is actually up. But that's without even having the international. I mean, the international is way down because of the restrictions. Domestic is actually up. And I think people know that this is a great place to be and a great place to visit. So we're going to make sure that we continue to do that. And I know that those are visiting. Welcome. And I hope you enjoy your stay. And everybody else here, Floridians, we're working to bring this relief to you. So stay tuned. God bless everybody.